Once it is dried, the pot is taken to the hardest reality of its making and becoming. The potter carefully places the pots one over the other onto a bed prepared for it. Then covers them with layers of hay. A soft layer of moist clay or husk is spread over it so that the heat remains within it. Totally unaware of what is in store, the pot remains inside the kiln. Then the potter, who had been very gentle and careful about the well-being of the pot, sets the fire around it. She feeds the fire constantly and gradually increases the amount of wood being added in order to raise the temperature. The burning fire invades its very being. The heat gets intense. The agonizing torture increases the anguish of the pot. It can neither resist nor understand as to why those gentle hands have to place his fine work into the heat of the burning fire. The pot has no way but to go through the excruciating pain of being baked. The atmosphere within a kiln during firing affects the appearance of the pot and produces irreversible changes in the body and permanently hardens it. This process enables the pot to endure the hard realities and tough moments in its life later. Just as the potter uses different temperatures for seasoning different types of pots, so also God uses different ways and events to mold us, to prepare us for a specific purpose. Finally, the seasoned pots are carefully brought out of the burning furnace. The pot now is on a journey to accomplish the purpose for which it is made. Every creation is a handiwork of God, formed out of formless and shapeless substance. We are a lump of clay spanned under the hands of the divine potter. He has formed every part of our body, the shape, color, gender, and emotions. Above all, he has put something of himself into every existing reality. Through his creation, the divine potter has translated his vision into purposeful realities. Though the clay is the same, the potter gives expression to a variety of pots. He envisions the multiple roles the clay can play. They come to the aid of drip irrigation. Water filled in earthen jars has a special cooling effect. Food prepared in earthen vessels offers a special aroma and taste. In some homes, earthen jars are used for storing food grains and other items. They enhance the look of surroundings, especially in flower gardens. The decorative utility of the earthen vessels is highly appreciated and adopted in art galleries, museums, institutions, and homes. Just as the potter makes different pots for different functions, so also God has filled each human person with different capacities to fulfill the given role. A pot in a glass case may remain spotless, dust-free, and still vibrant with its glow, because it has remained still, unaffected, and indifferent. Years of service and self-giving have caused the other pot to develop cracks and scars. Yet, it is for the broken pot to feel happy that if after many years of service it is cracked and worn out, then it had been at the service of its master and has accomplished the purpose for which it had been created. The lump of clay would never grow into a beautiful vessel if it stayed in the clay pit for thousands of years. But once put into the hands of a skillful potter and under his fashioning, it grows steadily into a vessel of honor and service.